know one of the nicest things that can happen to us? Well, say we come home from work sometime and we're dog tired and glad to get home. It's been a long day. You walk in the door, turn around, and all of a sudden there are 50 people screaming, "Surprise! Happy birthday," or "Happy anniversary," or something like that. You drop your packages on the floor and are in a state of shock for about 10 or 15 seconds. Finally, it all comes to you. Surprise party. Well, I'm only a party of one here, but since you're with me, that makes two, and that's a good start. Night Sounds on the air. I'm Bill Pearce, and thank you so much for joining me tonight. In fact, I've entitled our time together, "What a Surprise." And the subject centers around unexpected grace. Grace is a beautiful word. Biblically, its definition is unmerited favor. Well, we could even say unmerited surprise or unexpected love or grace. At any rate, I would be so appreciative tonight to you if you'd stay with me for these moments together. What a surprise. And as we move ahead, we're going to use another word, peace. Not so much a cessation of hostilities between enemies or nationalities or nations or anything like that, but peace, according to the Bible, that passes all understanding. Musically, an old gospel song with which we begin tonight, starting out with the strings, introducing a song entitled "The Peace That Jesus Gives." And that is different from any so-called peace we might experience, because it comes from God Himself, through grace, through love, through compassion. I thought I'd play two renditions of this particular selection tonight, beginning with trombone solo, an instrumental, just sort of establishing the melody of this beautiful piece of music. Enter the trombone. Beautiful number entitled "The Peace That Jesus Gives." In our program tonight, "What a Surprise," talking about unexpected grace. Somebody called me on the phone the other day and said, "I have had an unexpected miracle in my life." And what this person said was delightful. I don't know whether it would reach the category of an authentic, bona fide, validated miracle or not. Nonetheless, it was something that was very unusual, very unexpected, and very delightful. Someone said nothing in life is instant. People think miracles are instant, but really they're not. They're just a process that has been sped up because nothing God created is instant. Since God does not operate in the instant, He is a God of the potential principle. Everything begins as potential. In other words, He did not create a ready-made human race. The earth was not given an instant population. God made one person, not a million people. He began with one seed. Then from that, He created another. Then He said to those seeds, "Bless you." That means you have my permission. Be fruitful and multiply and replenish the earth. In Adam, the first man, God gave the earth a seed with the potential of 1, 100, 1,000, 1,000,000, and so on. And the 6+ billion people on earth right now were in that one man's loins. God knew that in Adam and Eve there were enough people to fill the earth. That's the way God works. He certainly knows the potential principle because He introduced that principle. It is Him. I passed a lady's boutique the other day in one of these large shopping centers, and there was a piece of jewelry in there, and the big sign over it was, "It's so me." I thought that was neat for some reason. It's so me. God, believe it or not, is so God. And in you, He can become even more so. In her book of poetry named Reflections on Life, Joyce Mumford wrote, "Come to life trustingly, palms up, to receive what may be given. Love will come, and joy. Welcome them, but hold them lightly. They must be willing guests. But if they go, and sorrow take their place, accept it with humility. It comes to all for a season, but only for a season. Keep your memories. Reach out to life hopefully, for love and joy will come again if they are free to go." Tonight's program, what a surprise. One of my favorite books that I read often for devotions and personal moments in the morning is a book that was written many, many years ago, way before I came on the scene, maybe you too, by a great saint of God of bygone years, Oswald Chambers. The title of the book, My Utmost for His Highest. One of the readings in here is entitled Gracious Uncertainty. In other words, a surprise party. And he takes his text from 1 John in the New Testament of the Bible, chapter 3, verse 2. And he commented, "Our natural inclination is to be so precise, trying always to forecast accurately what will happen next, that we look upon uncertainty as a negative thing. We think that we must reach some predetermined goal, but that's not the nature of the spiritual life. The nature of the spiritual life is that we are certain in our uncertainty. Consequently, we don't put down roots. Our common sense says, well, what if I were in that circumstance?" Mr. Chambers said, "We cannot presume to see ourselves in any circumstance in which we have never been." And that particular verse in 1 John reads, "It has not yet been revealed what we shall be." And then it goes on to say some of the things that we can expect when Jesus comes and what we shall be someday. Tonight's program, what a surprise. I thought it would be nice if we put some words to that song we just heard played instrumentally. This is the Ralph Carmichael group of singers, a CD made quite a while ago, but they take this particular piece of music, the peace that Jesus gives, and put wings to it. In other words, we hear not only the melody, but the lyrics as well. Beautiful music tonight On Night Sounds, the Ralph Carmichael Chorus, a song entitled The Peace That Jesus Gives. Just in case you may have joined us in the past few moments, you are in tune with Night Sounds. I'm Bill Pearce, and I welcome you. Tonight's program is titled What a Surprise. Well, maybe it's a surprise to have you with me tonight. It could be you're a first-time listener. And if so, I hope you can come back again. Basically, we have a good time here at nights. Sometimes in the early morning after midnight, too. Don't you love surprises? Especially when they're positive. I mean, a rear-end collision is a surprise, too, but who needs that? Night Sounds on the air, as we are just about every weeknight at this time on this station. And speaking of the radio station to which you're listening right now, I think it would be a great thing if you would call them on the phone, find out their address, write them a note, and say thank you for broadcasting such excellent programs as you do. And I certainly hope Night Sounds would be in the midst of that group. I would thank you for that, and certainly the station management would too. Because without them, we could not exist as a radio program. Tonight's title is What a Surprise. I'll be back to this in just a moment. Our time together is always a delight for me, and we meet new people all the time. If we can send you a catalog of the various attended ministries of this outreach, we want to do just that. We have about 12 or 13 record albums of vocal and instrumental music. And if you'd like information on that or anything else, we have a special info packet just for you. Our mailing address is Night Sounds, Wheaton, Illinois, 60189. And for those of you who are computer-oriented, the email address, nightsoundsradio, that's one word, at AOL.com. I heard of a young Christian student who went to university for the first time. And unfortunately, he had a professor in philosophy who was a rank agnostic. In other words, he didn't believe anything. In fact, he was an atheist. He didn't believe in God. He didn't believe in absolutes. And they were discussing absolutes in class. And the boy raised his hand and asked the instructor, "Are you sure, sir, that there are no absolutes?" And the instructor replied, "I'm certain of it." So verbally, we can get ourselves into a corner if we don't watch out, especially when we're speaking about absolutes and making a statement such as there is none, or such as the person did in the scriptures, who was retorted with, "The fool has said in his heart, there is no God." Tonight's program, What a Surprise. Quoting to some degree Oswald Chambers, great mystic of the past, he said, "Certainty is the mark of the common sense life. Gracious uncertainty is the mark of the spiritual life. To be certain of God means that we are uncertain in all our ways, not knowing what tomorrow may bring." So, this is generally expressed with a sigh and of sadness, but it should be an expression of breathless expectation. We are uncertain of the next step, but we are certain of God. And if we're not, we certainly can be. And as soon as we abandon ourselves to Him and do the task He's placed closest to us, He begins to fill our lives with surprises. And when we become simply a promoter or a defender of a particular belief, something within us dies. This is not believing God. It's only believing our belief about Him. Jesus said, "Unless you become as little children," Matthew 18. So the spiritual life is that of a child. And a child is surprised by joy. as he or she grows from infancy. Well, they play with pots and pans, and every toy is a brand new experience, and everything is full of wonderment. Let's not lose the wonder. When God blesses our hearts, it's a surprise sometimes. I've been surprised by his answers to prayer for other people. And it's just a beautiful thing to be able to be surprised by joy, something unexpected, something we hadn't perhaps even thought about at all. But it's there nonetheless. I believe we can surprise God too. Not that he doesn't know everything, but you know, a child can come to a father or a mother or a guardian and all of a sudden throw their arms around their neck and say, "I just love you." Or, "Look at this new toy I got," or whatever it might be. They're so full of wonderment. In our closing few moments tonight, I'd like to play another selection. This one is about God and his joy. God touching a human life. We can bless his heart too. Maybe we can surprise him with a note of praise and of gratitude and of joy and of obedience. The chorus and the song to bless your heart, Lord Jesus, is my desire. And we're into tonight's program with the title, What a Surprise. The realization of a dream is certainly a surprise in our lives. Leona Choi wrote, "Man lives on dreams. He thrives on hopes and visions that stretch his soul. Without dreaming, without reaching, without striving for the unattained, the human spirit withers. Mountains are to climb, rivers are to cross. Roads that disappear over the horizon must be followed to see where they lead. The passive mind, the self-satisfied heart, the unchallenged spirit shrivels and dries if it never sighs and dreams. Keep me dreaming, Lord. Give me visions, ageless and bold, as you've eternally given to the young and the old, by the touch of your spirit, author of dreams." Well, I want to thank you again sincerely for joining me tonight in these few moments. Hope you've been surprised by something today, are ready for a touch of joy and compassion and peace. Until we meet again then, I hope you have a great day tomorrow and a very pleasant and peaceful good night to all of you.